World Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action sanctioned by the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance.
And ladies and gentlemen, the summer is here. Hi, everybody. Tony Schiavone, David Crockett, and Jim Ross, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling. We are on the eve of the Great American Bash, and it all starts tomorrow in Orlando, Florida, David.
That's right. In Orlando, the bash starts, and what excitement's going to be there, Jim Ross?
Certainly is. All the top stars tomorrow night in Orlando, and all the top stars right here in the next 90 minutes here on the Superstation. And I want to address the situation fans having last week. Obviously, Patty did not like my questioning, and these questions were the questions that the fans had sent in. We hope to talk more about that situation and have her here next week to really clarify the situation and just exactly what that letter meant that we saw at Miami Mayhem that Kevin Sullivan had, something very special in that document.
A lot of big bash dates are coming up, including the big event coming up in Tampa on July 6th, David.
That's right, it's out stadium. All the fans in Tampa around that area come out and see the very best.
We'll be talking more about the Great American Bash and more about all the top stars, but right now I think we're ready with our first event. So let's go to the ring. There's no doubt it's really important to get the excitement rolling at the start of the program, and there's none better than Sting to start the excitement.
You're certainly right, Tony. The Stinger is one of the most charismatic, one of the most powerful athletes in the National Wrestling Alliance. And, of course, he and Nikita Koloff have a date with Destiny on the big pay-per-view event in Baltimore, Maryland on Sunday, July the 10th, when they will challenge the incomparable World Tag Team Champions Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard for the coveted gold. And I'll tell you something, the Stinger, he's pumped up, he's in great shape, we know he's motivated, and he and Nikita could certainly take those championships from the awesome champions on Sunday, July 10th in Baltimore.
Teddy Long, the referee, the opponent, Jerry Braxer, takes a hard slam from the Stinger. He came out firing, both guns loaded, as the old cliche goes, and he is red hot right now. It's tomorrow, fans. I know we can't wait. It's the Great American Bash, and we look forward to having you with us this entire summer. Now, Sting to the other side. Here he comes. Plastered him right to the corner, and that move that so many fans know about, the Scorpion Deathlock. You know, I say so many fans know about it. There's a lot of wrestlers that know about this move also.
No doubt about it. Right there is a very dangerous finishing maneuver. If Arn Anderson or Tully Blanchard find themselves in this predicament, no doubt we'll have new tag team champions. But getting them there is another story in itself, Tony, as we take another look at the closing moments of this contest. Look at that. Hang time. He leaves from the center of the ring. He may be in the NBA expansion draft. He's up in the lights.
Top quality athlete, his name is Sting. Plastering right into Jerry Price and then the Scorpion. Now David Crockett at ringside for the one and only Sting.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, the Stinger. And I see all the other Stingers out there.
Yeah, there's a few Stingers out there, all right. You know, they're howling too, let them get in close. It's just like this, though. Don't forget to use the hands just like that so everybody can hear it. You know, let's talk about the best of the pay-per-view. Right. Pay-per-view. You can buy it and get it in your own home. They have more fights in your living room than I had, let's say, in my living room a long time ago when I was having fun. You know what else I did, David?
What's that?
I went out and bought a little portable TV, you know, just in case. You see this right here. July 10th, the Big Bash. In Baltimore, where, yes, the total package. Yeah, it's going to do the number to the Nature World. But anyway, getting back to my portable TV, I bought it and thought, I'm going to have my cable hooked up to this thing, too. And I thought to myself, what am I doing? I'm in the thing.
That's right, you are.
Against Arn and Tully, yeah. I'm in it, and I can't wait. And if you come out there, buy one of these shirts, I swear to you, they'll have them in sizes that fit. See this thing? The bicep just kind of... what's a pop right out of there? Oh! Some people out there don't like the Stinger too much. Might say, well, he's got an extra small on. Ha! It's a double extra large. How's that?
it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the Stinger. The Great American Bash starts tomorrow in Orlando. Hang on.
I understand this classical selection is from the Soviet Union. I'm not up on their classical music. Theirs or ours, for that matter. But this man we know from the Soviet Union is the largest pro wrestler ever in the NWA from Russia, 6'8", 350 pounds. And we talked about dates with destiny. What about in Baltimore? This big man's going to be in the Tower of Doom as well. And then they've also got a Skywalker match signed with the Road Warriors later on this summer.
And you have to wonder, coming from a background, a Russian background, and we have seen so many great Russian athletes in the NWA, but none this big. So when Ivan Koloff went back home and plucked this man out, he really got a prize. Look at him. Gigantic.
You know, take a good look at him, fans. He's all man, I'll tell you that. And Tony, and I'm not saying anything disrespectful about the awesome Road Warriors, but looking in size comparison, just physical size, he towers over either Hawk or Animal. He is a giant of a man because both the Road Warriors are just simply awesome.
Pulling the man down, Robbie Almond into the ring, and then Ivan Koloff shoves him right outside. Look at the big man, the Russian assassin. Aptly named here. He's trying to put him out right on the floor.
A hard slam right here in the concrete, and Paul Jones with a very predicted cheap shot in my estimation.
You know, you wonder, Jim, about these Skywalker scaffold matches that Paul Jones has these men in. How will Paul Jones approach that? Because he always gets involved, but to do so, he's going to have to go upstairs.
I think in this situation, it's going to be 2-on-2. Because I don't think Jones, in any stretch of the imagination, is going to climb 20 feet above the ring and risk being knocked off to the concrete floor, no less, from 20 feet up in the air. But I'll tell you, at no time in history has a scaffold match featured four men this big. The combined poundage of these four men, well over 1,200 pounds.
That time, Almond was sent up to the lights.
Powers of pain. It follows me like a great white cloud.
Great white cloud, he says?
I don't know. He's a little deranged. His eyes are glazed over.
It follows many people like a great black cloud, maybe.
This man is just awesomely strong. That press slam had his putter right up in the lights, and here comes the Russian bear, Ivan Koloff, who just doesn't make many mistakes in the squared circle.
And I think a lot of the success, the early success of the Russian assassin, the way he looks in the ring, can be attributed to Ivan Koloff, because let's face it, he's probably never faced anything like this before over in the Soviet Union, but he has adapted quickly. The name of the game, of course, when Ivan Koloff is concerned is violence, and the man certainly is schooled in that as he nails Almond one more time behind the head and now communicating with Ivan Koloff, this gigantic man who is certainly going to be a big force. There's his move, Jim Ross.
The Russian guillotine. This is a violent maneuver. I've heard of the wrestlers in the NWA talking about this maneuver in the locker room. This is a very deadly and very dangerous maneuver. The officials got to use a lot of discretion here. Call it for the bell very quickly. A dangerous, dangerous situation here.
Your winners, Power of Pain, Paul Jones and his men, the Russian assassin, and of course, the Russian bear, Ivan Koloff. Here it is once again, Jim.
Look at the tremendous strength. Remember, this man is 6'8", 350 pounds. And when you think about the Tower of Doom, he'll be awesome in that. But when you really think about on top of the scaffold, it's really going to be scary with the Road Warriors.
A lot of people are asking, how can I see Ric Flair, Lex Luger, Barry Windham, Dusty Rhodes from Baltimore? Fans, here's how you can see it live.
What is the price for freedom? The Great American Bash 1988, The Price for Freedom, is a battleground where champions defend their titles at all costs, and the bloodthirsty contenders grapple for glory. Two living legends fight for their careers as Ric Flair takes on Lex Luger and Dusty Rhodes goes against U.S. heavyweight champion Barry Windham. Also featuring the first ever Triple Cage Tower of Doom match where 10 men struggle in a one-of-a-kind clash for honor. Plus, a 10 lashes to the loser tag team title match pitting the Fantastics against the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette in a straitjacket above the ring. And power meets power as Nikita Koloff and Sting tag up against the champions Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson. In a country where freedom is everything, the Great American Bash 1988, The Price for Freedom, is an event you can't afford to miss.
When you talk about the Great American Bash, Price for Freedom, you have to talk about the Powers of Pain, Paul Jones, the Russian Assassin, and Ivan Koloff.
You know, David, you can't deny that I am Powers of Pain. You've seen these two great Russians in the ring.
It was like they were born together.
I could holler and I could scream on television right now, and it's not going to do any good. The contracts are signed, and it all comes down, Road Warriors, when you step in that ring and you climb that cold steel to the top and you walk across that scaffold and you're looking at Ivan Koloff and you're looking at 6'8", 350 pounds, you're going to have a gut check. And brother, let me tell you something. I have Powers of Pain. I have the winning combination. I have the team that will climb the scaffold and get the job done. And Ivan Koloff, I can't thank you enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Paul Jones, the only one that's going to be crying in pain, hollering, is going to be the Road Warriors, because they're going to be yelling for mercy. They're going to be yelling, Uncle, all the way through the mat. They're going to be saying, I give up. Tampa Stadium, American bashes all over the United States. You're going to find out one thing. The Russian Assassin is stronger, better, tougher than the both Road Warriors together. And after the scaffold match, it's going to be the Legion of Doom, all right? It's going to be through for the Legion of Doom. And it is going to be because of Paul Jones and his commitment, along with myself, to get rid of the Road Warriors. Paul Ellery, you hear this, and you hear it well. We will not stop. And it's going to all come to an end, the Great American Bashes, this summer.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming up later in the program, you're going to hear from the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors. Also coming up next, you're going to see six-man tag team action.
A main event, the biggest, the best, the hardest hitting, and the most spectacular arena bouts in America can be seen on Superstation TBS. It's all action, and it's all right here. The NWA main event, 5:35 Eastern on Superstation TBS Sunday.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jim Ross back here for World Championship Wrestling here on the Superstation. I'd like to bring in Jim Crockett of the National Wrestling Alliance. Mr. Crockett, we've got a big summer ahead of us. The Bash, of course, starts tomorrow night. But one of the big events in Baltimore on July 10th is involved with Jim Cornette in a straitjacket. I know you've heard a lot about that.
I've heard a lot about that and from Mr. Cornette. But we've had the privilege of signing for some of the Bashes a handicap bunkhouse match. Jim Cornette in the ring in wrestling tights. This is worth seeing, believe me. Several years ago, we sort of coerced him into it, and he is going to be in a handicap bunkhouse match. Anything goes, but on July the 10th, Sunday, July the 10th, in a straitjacket, up in the top of the Baltimore Arena, where he can't interfere, the Fantastics take on the Midnight Express for the U.S. Tag Team title.
And, you know, he gets nosebleeds, you know, when he's that high up. And look who's joining us.
I think I have a phone call.
Good friend, buddy, pal. I've been trying. Here, you look a little thirsty. I brought you a Coke. Go ahead, take it. It's free. Listen, I got to tell you this, Jimmy. Now, I heard you talking about these matches, and I know this will come as a surprise to you. I've been trying to get you on the phone for the past couple weeks. We don't talk like we used to. You know that, Jimmy.
Yeah, that's right.
We used to be so close. But anyway, I've been trying to call you. You may not realize this is going to come as a surprise, but I never actually agreed to be in the bunkhouse match or to be in that straitjacket. It wasn't my idea, and I didn't want to do it. Now, I know you had you realized that you would have done something to change this all around and rearrange it. So I tell you what, if you'll do something, please, Jimmy, for me about that right now, then I'll be grateful. And also, my mother would be willing to pay you any amount of money for those contracts you want, even a
new
suit.
I've got a phone call.
A new suit?
Got a phone call.
What about a swimming pool?
Well, Mr. Crockett's got a phone call.
What is he doing?
He's what he's doing.
He's walking out on me again every time I come out here. Every time I come out here to talk to him, he won't return my calls and he walks away from me. Now, let me tell you something. As far as you live a chance in Baltimore goes, I know Jimmy Crockett's in on it. He wants to make an idiot out of me, but fantastic. I'm going to make an idiot out of you. And after those bunkhouse matches, you're going to realize you got to be full of courage, full of guts, and full of intestinal fortitude to wrestle. And believe me, everybody out there knows Jim Cornette is full of it.
Amen to that. No true words have ever been spoken. And I want to welcome my good friend Magnum T.A. here to the Superstation. Magnum, you're a big part of the Great American Bash this year. And I know this Friday night in the Scope Arena in Norfolk, a big one for you.
That's exactly right. You know, it's very seldom in one's lifetime that you get to relive the most intense moment of your career. My most intense memory of professional wrestling was the I Quit match I had back in 1985 with Tully Blanchard. And now I'm going to get to see that relived when the American Dream Dusty Rhodes meets Tully Blanchard in Norfolk, Virginia, my home, for another I Quit match. If they can relive the violence, the brutality of that match, I want to be right there watching it eyeball to eyeball. And I'll be there ringside watching American Dream take care of business. And Tully, you're in for another night of misery.
Magnum T.A., I mean the Great American Bashes, ladies and gentlemen. And now we're ready for six-man tag team competition.
All right, Jim Ross, Brad Armstrong, Kim Horner, Kendall Windham against the Cruel Connection and Max MacGyver.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Magnum's going to stay here with us. Magnum, this is a great six-man event. I know you're looking forward to seeing all the fans. Fans always love to see you when you go out, and especially in your hometown of Norfolk this Friday night.
Well, you know, it's a great time of the year. The Great American Bash has always bring the greatest talent all over the country, and I'm looking forward to being a part of it. I've been a part of it every year, and this year is not going to be any different.
You know, Magnum, we expect great bashes, of course, 1 week from tonight in Charlotte at the Memorial Stadium outdoors coming up. What a card. I know you've heard a lot about the big one in Tampa at Tampa Stadium. That's going to be a tremendous event in Tampa, Florida, outdoors at that magnificent facility.
Well, it's the greatest main events anywhere in the country. We got some great talent in the ring right now. You know, Tim Horner, Brad Armstrong, Kendall Windham. These three men can do a lot of damage on their own, and they're going to show us some good moves right here.
They are a great six-man combination, these three, the Lightning Express, and a great athletic move by Tim Horner, and a drop kick, and out comes Cruel Connection number one. The action is quick here.
That's why they call him the Lightning Express. Nobody moves around that ring quicker than Tim Horner.
Max MacGyver and both the Cruel Connection trying to get a little break in the action here. I do want to remind fans that tickets go on sale this Monday in St. Louis, Philadelphia, Jacksonville, and this Tuesday in Savannah, Georgia for great events coming your way. That's a reminder, you fans of St. Louis, Philadelphia, and Jacksonville. Monday's a big day for you.
You know, Jim, you can feel the intensity. Oh. Everybody's geared for the bashes. Brad Armstrong leaping off the top rope. I mean, everybody has their adrenaline pumped because they're getting ready for the greatest wrestling event in the world, and they're coming our way right around the corner.
You know, Magnum, you were always a tremendous competitor, but it seemed like from watching your career that when the Great American Bash came along, that the intensity in you rose. And I think that's perhaps a common trait in all great athletes. The big game is here. As a matter of fact, it kicks off tomorrow in Orlando.
That's right. You know, none of the old injuries matter. Nothing matters in this except when it starts out brand new. The Great American Bashes, everybody starts heads up because you got the greatest competition going out there, and you better get your best to give your best showing, or you just get left by the wayside.
You know, Magnum, two of our friends, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, back here with us for the Great American Bash, the special attraction. And they are just as super as they ever had, five times champions of the world.
That's why it's great to see Ricky and Robert back there. They are a big part of the NWA. They're a great part of this great wrestling world. And I'm glad to see them getting their self back on top and looking for those World Heavyweight Tag Team titles again themselves.
Great teamwork here by Kendall Windham, who certainly has, you got to think Kendall Windham's been through a lot of emotional ups and downs the last few weeks, Magnum, with Barry basically turning his back on family and friends and joining the Four Horsemen and really becoming one of the most dominant forces in wrestling today.
Well, you know, Kendall is finding out the adversity in life is what makes you strong. And I think we're going to see Kendall Windham emerge maybe out of the shadow of his brother now and become even a greater athlete than we've seen of him thus far.
He certainly has great motivation. We know he's a tremendous youngster. And here's another one, a second-generation athlete, Brad Armstrong, who is as technically sound as any athlete that I've seen in a long time. And I don't think that he has nearly reached his potential. Would you agree, Mike?
Not even close, because the man has all the tools, and they're well-honed. They're ready for action anytime. And the man is very seasoned as well. He just hasn't been in the right place at the right time for that big title shot, for that big break. But you know the man is just destined for greatness. And if he holds in there, longevity is going to be on his side. He's still a young man, this sport. And he is destined for greatness.
Pinning predicament by Brad Armstrong. Man, look at the great quickness he has. Arm drag, takedown, lightning fast. I got to ask you, Magnum, while you're here, Paul Jones has got the biggest Russian I've ever seen in my life at 6'8", 350. What are your thoughts on this situation involving the Road Warriors?
Well, you know, the Road Warriors, in my opinion, are and always have been the strongest team in professional wrestling. But it's not just their great physical strength that makes them so great. They're the most devastating force as well. Now with this new Russian, this great, big, huge man we know absolutely nothing about, it does throw a new element of surprise in there. And I don't know what's exactly going to happen when all that weight, all that power gets up on top of that scaffold 30 feet. Somebody's going to get hurt.
Well, no doubt about it. Just like Max MacGyver right there. Great double-teaming tactics by the Lightning Express. And Kendall Windham with a bulldog headlock. Magnum, that should be it right here.
That took all the wind out of his sails.
Great victory for the Lightning Express. Tim Horner, Brad Armstrong, and Kendall Windham here on World Championship Wrestling. And Magnum, thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Jim. Always a pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more World Championship Wrestling right after this week's Bam Slam.
Spam Slam is brought to you by Hormel, makers of Spam and other grocery products.
On this week's Spam Slam, we take a look at Tommy Rogers, one half of the Fantastics, and showing why he's part of the U.S. Tag Team Champion. Quickness and power with a power slam. Tommy Rogers with our Spam Slam of the Week.
Spam Slam is brought to you by Hormel, makers of Spam and other grocery products.
Know that the American Dream Dusty Rhodes is very deeply involved in this summer's Great American Bash. His situation with Barry Windham has certainly reached the boiling point. And earlier this week, in the Volunteer State of Tennessee, Dusty Rhodes had this to say with Tony Schiavone.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as we talked before, we are less than 1 week away right now from the big event. Right now, as Barry Windham is walking back to his dressing room, we'd like to bring in the one and only American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Jim Ross said it. It's almost time for the big event, and I know from seeing Barry Windham that he is prepared.
Ain't it good to be alive and raised in hell in Tennessee? Yeah! The bottom line is the Great American Bashes are now on the air, live and in color, Jack. Barry Windham, you're another but a yellow dog like the rest of the Four Horsemen. Then the bottom line is my man Stinger, my man Nikita Koloff, the Dr. Death, the baddest man in the world. And my brothers of the road warriors. We do taking names and writing them down. Now, as the name taking is over, the honey kicking gonna stop. It's gonna start now. It's gonna run through the summer, and it's hot, hot, hot in public, if you will. I've never been a man to back down from anybody. You got to understand, Barry Windham, you're a snotty-nosed punk kid. I'm going to take my U.S. title and put it back around my waist where it belongs. The other bottom line is that the world's heavyweight wrestling champion, the world's heavyweight wrestling champion, the nature boy, Ric Flair, finally now meets his greatest challenge. Lex Luger will be the new world's heavyweight wrestling champion. It made me think just a little bit in public again. Bob Dylan said one time, he said to me, Bobby D said, you know, sometime life is a drag, sometime life is a bust, but we all got to do what we must. We got to keep on, keep it on, baby. And now then, we gonna start keeping on, my brother's gonna kick some booty this summer, baby. That's the bottom line. I love you, Tennessee. I wanna say hello to all my fans, Fairview and Allen, Texas. The Big Dust is coming home tonight, baby.
Only American dream, Dusty Rhodes. And now we're going to take a look at Scott Putski for the first time going up against David Isley. And there's no doubt one look shows that this young man is a phenomenal athlete with a great background.
Well, I'll tell you, he's a second-generation wrestler, the son of Ivan Putski, great former star in the NWA, many appearances here on the Superstation. But this youngster is the starting fullback for the TCU Horned Frogs. He doesn't wrestle full-time. He's a youngster in this sport. And the NFL scouts are really drilling because this kid runs a 4.3 40. And Tony, as you know, it's very, very sudden.
Side headlock on David Isley. There is no doubt the response he received from the fans is just a small part of what he's going to be received like in the wars of the NWA.
Well, he's going to be debuting in the NWA in the state of Texas. I know he's really looking forward to being in Houston, Texas. Of course, 4th of July, the big one in Reunion Arena in Dallas. That's going to be a tremendous event. We look forward to seeing all the great fans in the Metroplex at Reunion Arena on the 4th of July. This youngster will be in Amarillo. He's a very proud Texan, as are so many of the stars here in the NWA.
Tie up once again, side headlock to David Isley. There is no doubt the makeup is there for the youngster. And there's no doubt that his father has taught him well because he has a lot of confidence in the ring. You can tell that.
Well, I'll tell you something. He's going to have a big decision to make, Tony. But next year at this time, if he wants to go to an NFL training camp or if he wants to start wrestling in the National Wrestling Alliance full time, that's a big decision this young man's going to have to make. Because with his size, he's a very compact 225-pounder. That's great size for a fullback with that 4.3 speed.
Tied up once again, Isley this time comes up with a side headlock. The Great American Bash means summertime excitement. And the first day of summer, of course, kicked in this week. And as we take a look at Scott Putski with a great belly-to-back suplex, the summer means three words. Very simple. Great American Bash.
Great American Bash, of course. Many fans don't understand the pay-per-view situation. Well, basically, it's a service of your local cable company. It allows you to watch this event live as it's happening, not tape delayed, but live as it's happening, just as Tony Schiavone and David and I'll be seeing it right at ringside. And you can do that right in the comfort of your own home. So that's exactly what it means. If you have cable, then quite obviously you have the opportunity to see this event via pay-per-view on Sunday, July the 10th.
And that's the Great American Bash, fans. Of course, live from the Baltimore Arena. Putski being tied up now by Isley. Great move. Just a power move right there to slam the man down.
This kid comes from a great athletic family, Tony. His uncle was the first soccer-style kicker for the University of Texas Longhorns. His father, a great college football player, and as we know, one of the strongest, most powerful men in wrestling. As you mentioned, has competed in the strongest man competition in many areas, so he's really a powerhouse.
Butchke with a double thrust, and now he is climbing up on the turnbuckle, still prone on the mat as Isley. Butchke perched up on there now. Look at this athlete. But the spring comes off with a splash, caught him, and pins him.
It came well over half the way across the ring. This kid has got a lot of fire and a lot of great athletic ability, Tony.
Okay, we'll talk to Scott right after this, fans.
Truly a great pleasure to welcome Scott Putski. Scott, football, wrestling, you have them both.
That's right, Dave. You know, football and wrestling right now, I'm concentrating on wrestling because, at this point in my career, being so young, I'm really grateful to have the opportunity to wrestle in this Great American Bash coming up in Houston, Texas. You know, I mean, for me, it's something that I've dreamed of. Since I was little, growing up, I've watched my father wrestle. He's trained me, and hey, I'm getting ready and ready for Houston, Texas.
All right, that's right. In Houston, Texas, the Great American Bash. Your father has a lot to do with your training, doesn't he?
Yes, sir, he sure does. My dad trains me not only in the ring, but in the weight room. We get in the gym all the time. My father just recently purchased the Gold's Gym in Austin, Texas. He's training me there every day with not only extensive weight training, but also running.
All right, Scott, welcome to the Superstation TBS and the Great American Bash. Ladies and gentlemen, more action to come right after this. The Russian nightmare, Nikita Koloff, and you have that Russian chain with you.
I got the chain with me because it's here! It's here! It's finally here for the show. I'm talking, of course, about the Great American Bash. Let me ask you something. What is, what night is Baltimore? What night is
Baltimore is the 10th of July.
Oh, that would be a good night to see for the Stinger and I to take the world tag team title from Anderson and Precious. I guess we're going to have to see just what happened now. And you already talked about the Russian chef, and I have this for a reason. And the reason is Al Perez. You see, there are many things, Al Perez, I can do with Faruski's stuff at the heart. Many things I can do with the Russian chef. And you are not going to like very many. Don't be mad.
You know, David, Nikita, it's time. But it's no time to go back to the chalkboard. It's no time to go back to the chalk time, brother. It's the Great American Bash. It's what every athlete strives for. Let me tell you, I'm going against the world TV title. Mike Rotunda, I've held a few belts in my time, and I've retired a few belts. Mike Rotunda, you're a great athlete. Syracuse. Well, I'm from the University of Oklahoma, and a four-time All-American. I know everything about wrestling, backwards and forwards. And I've tied up a few people. Now, the 10th, Baltimore, the Tower of Doom, the biggest thing in professional wrestling. Everybody in the world will be watching this match on TV, paid review. Let me tell you, with my brothers, the Road Warriors, I'll tell you one thing. When we get in that... See what I'm saying, David? Right there, the Road Warriors and myself and the Tower of Doom. Baltimore, you boys who are going to get in there with us, better be ready.
Is that what's going to happen in the Tower of Doom right now?
More than that, Nikita. More than that.
Oh, I can't wait to see.
All right, David, with two men who are ready, no doubt. And all of a sudden, exploding to the ring, the Road Warriors, Pocket Animal, they are back together. And I know they look very closely at the Russian Assassin.
They just couldn't wait any longer to get out here and tear somebody's head off. And that's exactly what they have done. And can you imagine? It will be a battle for survival 20 feet above the ring. 20 feet above the ring. And the Skywalker Showdown, never have four men that big ever got it on that high up in the air. Ladies and gentlemen, David Crockett is standing by at ringside with the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors.
That's right, the Legion of Doom, the Tower of Doom, and the Skywalkers, man.
No, son, David Crockett, every second year when there's some kind of different or crazy match to be held. Who the hell do you think that call? They call my brother off, and they call myself to kick somebody's butt. Now I have a call off. You're out here telling everybody that the end is going to come for the Road Warriors. Who are you trying to kid? You've tried with Pantra. You've tried with the other bum that had to put a challenge in legs and ran out of town. That's how badly beat them up. It don't matter. We've taken on all comers, and we will continue to prove to you and to everybody else why we're the number one tag team in the world. Tell them, brother. From the streets of Chicago to the Tower of Doom, and in between a few spaz attacks in the fourth ward of St. Pete, we've come a long way. We're always coming strong. That's what the LOD is all about. You see, we really don't care about anything. Matter of fact, we filed for our 16-8 long ago. The Tower of Doom is the pinnacle of professional wrestling. And we are the middle of the pinnacle, the top of the line, the cream of the creme. We're the best that wrestling has to offer. A lot of people don't like to admit it.
because they don't want to give us credit. But we're what makes everything in professional wrestling kick. We snack on danger. We dine on death. Dead men don't make money. That's the bottom line in our book. Yeah.
Well, David, it appears to me that there's a lot of wrestlers and a lot of individuals getting facts mixed up with outlandish theory. Kevin Sullivan, you designed a match called the Tower of Doom. Well, this match was designed for the Legion of Doom. You set a piece of bait in there. You set a hunk of cheese. And the only free cheese in wrestling belongs in the trap of the Road Warriors and the Legion of Doom.
The Great American Bash, taking America by storm. More action. Stay tuned.
World Championship Wrestling, the stars of the NWA at the Greensboro Coliseum. Greensboro, North Carolina, Saturday, July 16th, 8 o'clock in Greensboro. The Baltimore Arena, Baltimore, Maryland, Sunday, July 10th at 6:30 in Baltimore. The UIC Pavilion, Chicago, Illinois, Saturday, July 9th, 8 o'clock in Chicago. The Civic Arena, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Friday, July 8th, 8 o'clock in Pittsburgh. The Norton Arena, Raleigh, North Carolina, Thursday, July 7th, 8 o'clock in Raleigh. Tampa Stadium, Tampa, Florida, Wednesday, July 6th, 8 o'clock at Tampa Stadium. The Knight Center in Miami, the NWA returns on Tuesday, July 5th, 8 o'clock at the Knight Center in Miami. Reunion Arena, Dallas, Texas, Monday, the 4th of July. That's on Monday, July 4th, 8 o'clock at All Stars in Dallas. The Civic Center Arena, Amarillo, Texas, Sunday, July 3rd at 8 o'clock in Amarillo. Memorial Stadium, Charlotte, North Carolina, Saturday, July 2nd, 7 o'clock at the Stadium in Charlotte. The Scope Coliseum in Norfolk, Virginia, on Friday, July 1st, 8 o'clock, the bell time at the Norfolk Scope. The Township Auditorium, Columbia, South Carolina, Tuesday, June 28th. It all starts at 8 o'clock in Columbia. Memorial Auditorium, Greenville, South Carolina, with a bell time of 8 o'clock on Monday, June 27th. That's Monday, June 27th, 8 o'clock in Greenville. Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, the Orange County Convention Sewage Center in Orlando. That's tomorrow night, 8 o'clock in Orlando. The NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance, is the major league of professional wrestling, the NWA.
Wagner, you know, the Great American Bash affects everybody. It's the talk of the street everywhere you go. Fans contact us all the time about excitement in the NWA. Speaking of fans, let's say hello to Mabel Kilpatrick, who works at the Cupboard Restaurant in Charlotte. She's a big fan of Jim Ross and Jim Cornette.
And they make good gravy there and biscuits.
Now, Nikita Koloff, right on the back of Ryan Wagner.
The Rock and Roll Express have really excited a lot of crowds. And the NWA, I'll tell you something, for years, and no doubt this summer when the reunion of the Rock and Roll back in the NWA is really going to be exciting. Ricky and Robert looking really great. Nikita Koloff certainly has his hands full. The situation not only with the Stinger and Nikita challenging the Four Horsemen, that big matchup on Sunday, July 10th in Baltimore just may be the stiffest challenge that the Horsemen will face all summer regarding the Tag Team Championship of the World.
You know, we talk so much about conditioning and coming out of the bashes in one piece, so to speak. Certainly, as Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson look at their opponents, they know that they're going to have to be in great condition, which they will be, for Baltimore, Sunday, July 10th. And there you see, on a pay-per-view basis only, you can bring it to your own home.
Certainly can, right through your cable company, your local cable company can bring it right into your living room so your whole family can see it live as it happens. I'll tell you something, the great bash, 1 week from tonight, in your hometown, Tony, Charlotte, Memorial Stadium, outdoors. Great crowd expected. Great family environment in Charlotte 1 week from tonight, outdoors.
And I know the fans love the Rock and Roll Express in Charlotte. They're coming back, and they'll be at the stadium in that event, the return of Ricky and Robert.
Nikita Koloff has certainly controlled this situation with Ryan Wagner. There is the dreaded Russian sickle. Nikita Koloff is an awesome individual. And with the Stinger, they just might be the odds-on favorite to wrest the World Tag Team Championship away from the Four Horsemen.
But you know, and everybody knows, it's bash time, so you got to kind of stand in line because everybody's going to be taking shots at the champions. But with moves like this, the Russian Sickle, there's no doubt Nikita Koloff is well on his way to a big summer. Now, fans, when we take a look at Nikita Koloff, let's go to David Crockett.
The NWA World Television Champion, Mike Rotundo, the Games Master, Kevin Sullivan,
Mr. Rotundo, you heard Dr. Death out here. He's going to take that title away.
Well, I'll tell you something, David Crockett. As you know, and if you don't know, I'm going to tell you. Syracuse University graduates no idiots. I'm not out here beating my brains out because I know I have to defend this title against Dr. Death, Sting, and the list goes on and on. I'm going to put the title up more times than any time before in a string every night in the Great American Bashes. This title will be on stake. But I'm going to tell you something. Sting is out here talking about bringing a portable TV. He can bring it because if he gets in the ring with me, he's going to see his face being rubbed in the mat. The varsity club knows what's going on here. And I'm going to tell you what, this title means a lot to me because if I get through all the bashes as a champion, I'm going to get my shot at the world title. And Steiner's off in a Turkish bath tonight, and I know the Games Master here is ready for the Temple of Doom.
All right, Games Master, you have the envelope.
I want to say one thing, and it's real clear. I hear the road warriors out here, and they do tell the truth. They are men as hell, and I must be a little deranged to get in the Tower of Doom with them. But I'm also telling the truth. I've told the truth about everything since I've been here. I told the truth that Dusty Rhodes will become the United States champion. Now, last week, somebody lied on this program, and there was two people talking. One was me, and the other one was Patty. You see, you put her in a bad position.
No, wait a minute. You're the liar. There's nothing in there. There's nothing in that.
David Crockett.
She said it was, right?
Do you know women at all? Obviously you do, because they're all liars at one point. What happened was Jim Ross put her in a real bad situation last week. He brought her out here with Jimmy Garvin. Bring her out here because Patty, it's right here. It's documented. It proves that I'm a liar. And David Crockett, there it is. Bring it back to me because it's mine personally. Read it. And we're going to find out who the liar is because in the Temple of Doom, I'm going to make one thing clear. Patty, if you don't come with me, I'm going to take that pretty little face because you're in the bottom of it and you got the key. And it'll be hell to pay because I'll get to the cage. And Patty, if I can't have you, I'm going to make sure you look ugly that nobody wants.
Let's go to the ring, folks.
The Sheepherders against the Italian Stallion and Rick Allen in this event on World Championship Wrestling, as Kevin Sullivan had some very bold statements out here. So we're taking a look at the New Zealand War Haka.
What was that now?
Haka. That's real repulsive, fans. We'll be right back right after this timeout. Only on the Superstation can you see the stars of the Major League of Professional Wrestling, the NWA. Tony Schiavone, Jim Ross, and David Crockett ringside with World Championship Wrestling. We were talking about the Great American Bash and the return of Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express. You know, when you're in the sport, Jim, you get friends and you get enemies. Certainly, enemies of the Rock and Roll Express have to be the Sheepherders.
Well, I'll tell you something. That started a long, long time ago. The Sheepherders and the Rock and Roll Express, and it certainly looks like it's going to culminate this summer during the Great American Bash. The Rock and Roll, Ricky and Robert, we know great young Americans. Very patriotic from the volunteer state of Tennessee, those two kids. And they certainly don't like people talking negatively about the USA. The Sheepherders say they're superior to the Rock and Roll Express and are really going to take care of them this summer. That remains to be seen.
There's no doubt the Sheepherders are capable not only of taking care of the Rock and Roll Express, but most anybody. As Luke Williams slowly gets up, the Stallion comes off right on the shoulder of Williams, who goes down.
Tony, just to digress just for a moment, I think there's more to this situation with Kevin Sullivan and Precious that meets the eye, and I think that there was something in the past between those two. I don't know what it was, but it's quite obvious that I wish you'd have been here last week. You could have maybe you'd done the interview. We could have flipped a coin.
Well, I saw the interview, Jim, and I know it was really a tough situation for you personally, but being in Baltimore like I was last week, I know that the fans are ready for the Tower of Doom. And I know fans in Baltimore are thinking, because they're great NWA fans, what's going to happen? What's the lady going to do down at the bottom? Who will she let out? Which way will she go?
That's a very good question. Where does her allegiance lie? And next week here on the program, we're going to address that situation. Maybe we can get her here in the studio next week and talk to her about that letter. David Crockett's going to be holding that for safekeeping.
Well, we're taking a look at one awesome tag team right here.
the Sheepherders, there's no doubt, when they heard of the return of Ricky and Robert, they got prepared for the Great American Bash. They knew the Bashers would be tough, but little did they know how tough they would be for them. Ricky and Robert are back, and I must say, looking better than ever. You know, we saw Ricky and Robert on the Clash of the Champions Miami Mayhem, and Robert really looked good. So did Ricky, and I think they're going to come back better than ever before.
Former four-time tag team champions of the world. I think I said five times earlier in the program. Being a little presumptuous there, they've won it four times. That's an unprecedented feat in the NWA. I'd like to say hello to our fans in Pittsburgh, Chicago, St. Louis, Philadelphia. Certainly, wrestling capitals of the NWA in this summer. It is going to be some of the greatest events ever.
Yeah, and especially fans in St. Louis and Philadelphia, Jacksonville, Florida, and remember, this Monday, tickets go on sale for your big events. Don't forget, in Philadelphia, St. Louis, and Jacksonville.
Oh, that's really using your head there. The human battering ram from the New Zealand Sheepherders as Luke Williams grabs Mr. Allen and makes a tag. They certainly are well-schooled in tagging in and out. They're rough, they're rugged, but they communicate quite well.
Double knee drop here. Their nephew, Rip Morgan, on the outside. He grew up with the Sheep down there in New Zealand. These guys are a little bit weird, I'll tell you that right now. It will be a physical situation when they meet Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. And ladies and gentlemen, David Crockett will talk to them right after you hear this very important message.
Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, when these guys heard they were coming, look at them now. The New England Sleepers.
Hello, David Crockett! The great international bash! That's the Mariusy! And everybody around the world is going to be there, David Crockett.
That's right, Captain. Everybody.
And when we knew those two punk kids that were three times NWA Tag Team Champions, the biggest folk heroes in Tag Team Wrestling, came back, we're talking about the Rock and Roll Express, David Crockett. You see, once before we chase them off, and the time is this, we do the same because, David Crockett, they got one thing wrong. They were born in the USA. That means they're bloody Yanks. And because they're bloody Yanks, they suffer at the hands of the Sheepherders because we do not like bloody Yanks. Rock and Roll Express. It's the end for you at the best. It's the bloody end.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the World Tag Team Champions are coming up next.
The World Tag Team Champions, Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, along with the leader of the Horsemen, James J. Dillon, and Tony Bowen and Joe Cruz. So we take a look at the NWA World Tag Team Champions. Certainly those belts will be on the line against the likes of Nikita Koloff and Sting. But when you think about War Games, the match beyond, you think about really getting your shots at the Horsemen there also.
Well, one thing about it, Tony, of course, we have talked a great deal about Sunday, July 10th in Baltimore, when this will be a night of champions, when the Horsemen put it all on the line, all their credibility, all their prestige, their future, their investments. Every championship on the line. And I think that Nikita Koloff and Sting have a great combination, have a great chemistry. And J.J. Dillon standing right here, I know he scouted them immensely, but this is a great team, J.J., Nikita Koloff and Sting. And I think they're going to be more than ready to meet the challenge on July the 10th.
Well, that's what the Great American Bash is all about. It's the best against the best. The best the NWA has to offer. And it's a Great American Bash, but really it's an international thing, because everywhere we've traveled, and I know recently the last couple of weeks we were down in the Caribbean, we were down at the Pelican Resort in St. Martin, and everybody came up and the topic of conversation was the Great American Bash. Everybody wanting to know my picks on the different matches. The next day we went to St. Thomas, and Mr. George Formicus, the managing director there at the Virgin Isle Hotel, that was our base while there. That's all he wanted to know. Every time he had a few minutes, he'd ask me to come into his office. He wanted to know who I was picking, whether I was going with Flair or Luger. Is really Luger the man that's destined to be the next World Heavyweight Champion? And I told him that Ric Flair is prepared for this match like none other. Temple of Doom, everybody has seen the drawings.
They've seen the ancient parchment. Everywhere we went in St. Thomas, we had a security director, Basil, that was trying to keep the fans away from Ric Flair and all the NWA stars. But everybody wanted to know just what is the Temple of Doom. Well, it's hard to describe because, frankly, I haven't seen it myself. All I've seen is the drawings. But just the idea of three cages piled on top of each other, 10 men climbing through trap doors, and then Precious, with all that she's been through down at the bottom, knowing that people are going to come through. Can you imagine her looking up when that trap door opens, not knowing if it's Kevin Sullivan that's going to drop through there, or one of the Road Warriors? And what happens when everybody gets down there? She's going to be at the mercy of whoever it is, and she's really got the secret to get out of the cage, because she is the one that has the key, and she can't leave until either one team or the other is completely eliminated, and she can leave with him. July 10th in Baltimore will certainly be the biggest night of the year for the NWA.
And you know, in the same light, this entire summer, Jim, not only important to many fans, but I would think the most important month and a half in the history of the Four Horsemen, wouldn't you say? With Baltimore, with the War Games coming up also?
Well, the Horsemen are going to be tested in every major arena, every major venue across this country for the Made in America Bash, and we will be prepared.
No doubt about that. James J. Dillon making those comments. Thank him for stopping by. And we have seen the Horsemen with a very devastating victory here. And speaking of devastating, the confrontation for the Undisputed Heavyweight Championship of the World happens on Sunday, July 10th, the only title defense of the summer for the Nature Boy. How's he feel about it? How's he been training? He's standing by now with David Crockett.
Hello, David.
How long will he hold on to it? How long will you hold on to the world heavyweight title? July 10th in Baltimore, Lex Luger says he's got your number.
Well, David Crockett, have I paid any attention to all the wrestlers over the years that have said they've got my number? I would have left this great sport years ago. But the bottom line is, and it's really difficult at times for the wrestling fans or the sports fans around the world to accept the very bottom in this sport. And that is this: if you are the best at what you do, then you win at any cost. And myself, Ric Flair, just like the Los Angeles Lakers, will repeat one more time. Think about it. Now, I'm not standing out here in a bicycle shirt. I'm not wearing a Great American Bash t-shirt. The sports world and the wrestling world know what's taking place. The Great American Bash, Baltimore, Maryland, July 10th. Lex Luger, the physical phenomenon, the man that the experts are saying is going to beat Ric Flair, the man that in Baltimore, Maryland, and let's put this in the right perspective, there are over 9 million people worldwide that'll be watching this on their television screens. There'll be 15,000 people in Baltimore, Maryland. And when I walk that out, when I break that curtain, woo, look at it, only I can look. Luger, now think about it, Lex Luger. We're talking about 3 weeks. You, my friend, have got to walk that aisle. You've got to fulfill the dreams of a lifetime. You've got to become one of the chosen few. You got to beat the reigning world heavyweight champion. There's only one. Jim Crockett Promotions, the National Wrestling Alliance, make me the bottom line best wrestler in the world today, because I am the world heavyweight champion. Baltimore, think about it, Luger, 9 million people. The world will be watching to see if in 60 minutes, you can become the very best there is. Now, starting tomorrow night in Orlando, Florida, oh, my friend, the Road Warriors, think about it. You stand out here all painted up, talking about life or death. For anybody that follows wrestling, read the magazines.
Ask your friends, Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, Barry Windham, and Jim Dillon are the nucleus that make our team go round and round. And each and every night of every bash, we will put our credibility and our careers on the line. We've had bitches, we've had broken bones, we have paid the price individually and as a team. And I'm saying right now, Luger, starting in Orlando tomorrow, or Chicago, or Pittsburgh, you aren't going to make it to Baltimore because you're going to have to pay God's price for walking around Baltimore. And if you make it to Baltimore, pal, look at what you have to beat. The very best there is.
Ric Flair, the world heavyweight champion, the great American Bash, the whole world is watching.
Oh, there's some very physical situations, just like in Baltimore. He's going to be in the first Tower of Doom match. And I'll tell you what, I'd want him on my side in that situation. Oh, what a clothesline.
And as we take a look at the dock, and he's about ready to take care of Big Bear Collie for good here. As you can see, he is unloading on. He wants to say hello to the fans once again in Tampa, Florida. You know, Tampa Stadium has had some legendary battles. Look at him picking up Big Bear Collie, over 300 pounds for the Stampede.
This is what you're going to see in Tampa, ladies and gentlemen. It's like the whole ring just came crumbling down there. Two 300-pounders crashing down. Dr. Death has manhandled Big Bear Collie here on the program. He is a big, big physical man.
All right, here's the Stampede once again. David Crockett will be talking to Lex Luger momentarily, but we're going to take a look at the Oklahoma Stampede. Remind you again, Tampa Stadium is Wednesday, the 6th of July. Outdoors, the bash, the return of Dusty Rhodes, Lex Luger, and many others. Now to David Crockett.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard Ric Flair. July 10th in Baltimore, Lex. What's going to happen?
You know, David Crockett, I'm glad, nature boy, that you are so very confident, so cocky, because when you want to be the best, you do want to beat the best, and I want you to be your very best in Baltimore on July 10th, Fisher boy, because you know, for so many years you've been styled and profiled, you've wrestled all the best, you've proven yourself against all the best competitors, except one. And he's standing here looking you in the eye right now. You've avoided me with Arn. You've avoided me with Tully. You've avoided me with Barry Windham. And now it's come to pass. You see, Nature Boy, when they were stitching my head up in the hospital, asking if I want to press charges, or Jim Crockett want to take some kind of action, I said no, because I knew I'd get out of the hospital. And I knew that July 10th, and it's getting close, I can feel it, that it would roll around. And then, you see, Nature Boy, I've got you. Oh, man. Nature Boy, I've got you for 1 hour. And you know what? When you and four others committed assault in a parking lot, but now it's my turn, because one-on-one, for 60 minutes, I can do anything I want to you. I can beat you up any way I want. And nobody can do anything about it. No charges will be brought down on a total package, Lex Luger. Something big gonna happen in Baltimore July 10th. And it's a name in 270 pounds. You take a look at what you're gonna face July 10th, Mr. Boy. And you sleep on that.
The match of the century for the world heavyweight title, July 10th in Baltimore.
Oh, the gold they do have. We're talking about the Horseman, another champion, Barry Windham, United States heavyweight champion. He's gearing up for the battle of his life against Dusty Rhodes, and you can tell he's gearing up by going at it 100% Mr. Intensity.
Well, his pending battle with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, whether it be in Baltimore or any other type of situation, tag matches or whatever it may be, are going to be tremendous. Here comes that big suplex, the superplex off the second rope. Next week, it's going to could be fireworks right here, Tony. Kevin Sullivan's going to be back. We've invited Patty to come back and tell us more about that letter situation. And Barry Windham has made short work of this one. This one is history.
There it is. Barry Windham, your winner, the U.S. champion. He and J.J. making their way over to talk to David Crockett to end out our program today. Let's take a look at the superplex. I know fans out there are ready for tomorrow in Orlando. We are also. Jim Ross and I will see you there in Orlando as we kick off the bash. Now let's go to David Crockett.
J.J. Dillon, Dusty Rhodes says he's going to take this away from Barry Windham.
Well, let me put everything into proper perspective. A little earlier in today's program, I mentioned just one isolated incident. I indicated the treatment that we received from Mr. George Formicus at the Virgin Isle Hotel down in St. Thomas. The reason that we receive the finest accommodations every night, the best food that can be laid out, the best champagne that can possibly be served, is because Ric Flair is the world champion. Tully and Arn are the world tag team champions, and Barry Windham is the United States heavyweight champion. And the Great American Bash on July 10th in particular is the proven ground as to whether each of the four horsemen deserves and is worthy to continue to carry the gold. I think they are. I know they are. But apparently they've got to prove it to a lot of people across this country. And to put it all in proper perspective, there are 9.7 million potential homes that can watch the event live in their home on pay-per-view. Will you multiply that up by a minimum of at least three persons per home, you can really start to appreciate what I'm talking about. July 10th, the Great American Bash in Baltimore will be the most watched sporting event and certainly any wrestling event in this decade. So the only thing I can say is whether you're fans of the Four Horsemen or not, this is going to be the event of a lifetime. And brother, I wouldn't miss it. And Dusty Rhodes, if anybody's going to miss it, brother, I bet you wish it's going to be you when Barry Windham finishes with you July 10th.
You know, I'll tell you what, Dusty Rhodes seems to think that he is the man that teaches the lessons around here. Well, let me tell you what, Dusty Rhodes, the United States Heavyweight Championship belongs to Barry Windham, and I'm going to teach you a lesson just like I just taught that clown. You think the superplex is something you're going to walk away from? Well, you're way over 300 pounds, big boy. And I'm going to put you on the top rope, and I'm going to beat you like you've never been beat before, and I'm going to walk out of there the champ.
The Great American Bash coming your way in Baltimore.
Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action sanctioned by the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance.
There is
No doubt, the momentum is building as the summer is here, and of course, the Great American Bash. Hi, everybody. Tony Schiavone, Jim Ross, and David Crockett ringside with the NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. And David, the Great American Bash is hot and upon us.
That's right. The Great American Bash is in Charlotte, North Carolina tonight, and that's where the bash started. Jim Ross?
Well, I'll tell you what, fans. Last week we told you that we're going to do our best to have Precious here in the studio. We have done that. She will be here with us. Plus, we're going to see Kevin Sullivan. That's a powder keg in itself, Tony. Okay, right now, though, we have all the top stars in our sport. Let's bring in the one and only World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Now, July 10th, they call it the ultimate confrontation. Nature Boy Ric Flair and Lex Luger for the World Heavyweight title.
Well, it's all happened. Tony Schiavone, the controversy lies, but all of it settled. Because Sunday night, July 10th, 1 week and 1 day, Ric Flair, the world heavyweight champion, will walk that aisle knowing without a doubt that in his mind and in the mind of all the wrestling experts, he's the very best this sport has to offer. Then Lex Luger, the greatest physical phenomenon to ever come along in professional wrestling. The youth, the speed, the endurance, the hunger to become number one, walks the other aisle. Now, Luger, I'm glad to be involved in such a great match. It's a great honor for Ric Flair to be recognized as the world champion. But, pal, you will never see Ric Flair drop that title or be defeated in Baltimore, Maryland. The bottom line is, Luger, you're going to have to dig down deep inside. It's not going to be those muscles. It's not going to be all that glamour and all that glory. It's going to be your ability and your ability alone that'll put you on top of Ric Flair. You've got to be able, pal, to walk that aisle and do what you promised the world you can do. Buddy, don't bet on it, because Ric Flair and diamonds are forever.
Fans, another 2 men in the spotlight are Barry Windham and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Let's go up to the ring. David Crockett with the U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
The student and the pupil, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Barry Windham, Dusty Rhodes, July 10th, Baltimore.
You know, I'll tell you what, the Nature Boy laid it down right there. He said it's 1 week away.
Well, I will tell you what, 1 week is all you have left, Dusty Rhodes. 1 week is all that you have left in your wrestling career.
Because what you're going to do is go home and tell your wife how bad that your student was on this given day. Because I am going to give you the wrestling lesson of your life. And this championship right here, Dusty Rhodes, is going to stay in the horseman camp. J.J. Dillon has assured me, and I have been training as hard as I ever have in my life, to keep the United States Heavyweight Championship. Dusty Rhodes, look at me very close. You've known me for a long, long time. There's no fear in my eyes and no fear in my heart. When I step into the ring with you, I'm going to do whatever it takes, picking you up, putting you up on the top rope, and dropping you down 15 feet, be it when I'm stretched out 15 feet to the mat. You are not going to walk out of Baltimore the United States Heavyweight Champion.
One particular thing before you walk away. Dusty Rhodes made the statement he taught you everything but one thing, and that was how to lose. That's the one thing he never had to teach you, because you're not a loser. You never have been and never will be a loser.
I never learned, J.J. I never learned.
All right, let's go to Tony and Jim Ross.
All right, David, thank you. There's no doubt it's the biggest moment in both careers of Ric Flair and Barry Windham, but they're well prepared. No doubt about it, it's going to be one of the most emotional situations. I've said that for quite some time, involving the American Dream and his former friend, very close friends, Barry Windham. But fans, there's another man in the ring that is certainly no stranger to championships. He'll be in Baltimore and the Tower of Doom to come no tougher than Ronnie Garvin. Go to the ring. The man with a hand of stone, Ron Garvin, against Larry Stevens. And you know, Jim, you said it right. He is not a stranger to being a champion. Only 41 men have held the NWA World Heavyweight title. And Ric Flair, of course, holding the title, but Ronnie Garvin was the last man to hold the belt.
Well, Ronnie Garvin has certainly had a lot of challenges. I know the Garvin family involving this situation with Kevin Sullivan, but Ronnie Garvin has stood steadfast with his brother Jimmy Garvin. Ronnie Garvin has not wavered. His loyalty and his support of his brother's problems has been foremost on his mind, I know. And Ronnie Garvin will most certainly be in Baltimore. Will be involved in that three-story Tower of Doom situation involving Kevin Sullivan. And the people involved in that Tower of Doom match, Tony, it's the toughest men in wrestling without a doubt are signed. The 10 men in that are as tough as they come. There's no doubt about it.
There is no doubt in the Tower of Doom, Ron Garvin is one of the toughest men alive. And Ron Garvin, of course, former world heavyweight champion, one of the top wrestlers in our sport. Now the Road Warriors are going to be involved. Ron Garvin, of course, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, Dr. Death Steve Williams. Those all are on one team.
You're exactly right. That's going to be, I think, one of the most exciting confrontations. And it's the structure itself of the Tower of Doom is really breathtaking. It's like looking at a three-story building, except you can see through it because you can see through the chains, see through the cage. Really something that will happen in Baltimore. And Ronnie Garvin has certainly intimidated Larry Stevens thus far in this contest. We do want to remind all the fans, Tony, tomorrow night you and I will be in Amarillo, Texas for a tremendous event, the Great American Bash in Amarillo. That's going to be something. Of course, the big one at the Reunion Arena this Monday night in Dallas, 4th of July, will be red hot in the Metroplex.
Ronnie Garvin now standing on Stevens, running the corner, and our official here today, Teddy Long, warning Ronnie Garvin of his tactics. But Ronnie holding right on. You know, you hear from Ric Flair, and you hear from Barry Windham. The intensity is there. You can see it in Ronnie Garvin. And it all has to do with being champions. And with champions, you have a lot of money involved, a lot more for a winner's purse than a loser's purse. So not only are you talking about wanting to be a champion, but you're also talking about wanting to win a lot of money.
And when we talk about the Great American Bash in Baltimore on Sunday, July the 10th, this event, ladies and gentlemen, will not be shown here on TBS. It will be available only in your home on pay-per-view. That is, unless you have a ticket for the big event in Baltimore. So if you don't plan on being in Baltimore or have a ticket, you can get the event in your home via your cable company.
So your cable company can do that for you. And right now, Ronnie Garvin's doing a lot to flatten Larry Stevens, who just rolls right out of the ring, the man with the hands of stone. He's always light on his feet. He has a terrific knockout punch, but he is a terrific all-around wrestler. All attributes for Ronnie Garvin. And with the high vertical outside-in suplex, he is ready to unload on Larry Stevens. There it goes.
Ronnie Garvin just exploded with that big right hand, and as I said, through all the trouble, the trials and tribulations, he has stood fast with his brother Jimmy Garvin, and together the Garvin family will try to ward off this situation with the Varsity Club in the Tower of Doom in Baltimore and take one look at this big right hand. You know what I mean. This man, the former champion, is as tough as they come.
The Great American Bash means as much as anything else, violence in the ring at times, and what a better way to start out with a real violent man. Ronnie Garvin. We'll be back, fans. Don't you dare go away.
World Championship Wrestling, the stars of the NWA at the Greensboro Coliseum, Greensboro, North Carolina, Saturday, July 16th, 8 o'clock in Greensboro, the UTC Arena, Chattanooga, Tennessee, Thursday, July 14th, 8 o'clock in Chattanooga, the Broadbent Arena, Louisville, Kentucky, Wednesday, July 13th, 8 o'clock in Louisville, the Von Braun Civic Center, Huntsville, Alabama, Tuesday, July 12th, 8 o'clock in Huntsville, the Wicomico Youth Civic Center in Salisbury, Maryland, Monday, July 11th, 8 o'clock in Salisbury, the Baltimore Arena, Baltimore, Maryland, Sunday, July 10th at 6:30 in Baltimore. The UIC Pavilion, Chicago, Illinois, Saturday, July 9th, 8 o'clock in Chicago. The Civic Arena, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Friday, July 8th, 8 o'clock, that's in Pittsburgh at the Civic Arena. The Dorton Arena, Raleigh, North Carolina, Thursday, July 7th, 8 o'clock in Raleigh. Tampa Stadium, Tampa, Florida, Wednesday, July 6th, 8 o'clock in Tampa Stadium. The Knight Center in Miami on Tuesday, July 5th, 8 o'clock at the Knight Center in Miami. Reunion Arena, Dallas, Texas, Monday, the 4th of July. That's Monday, July 4th, 8 o'clock at Reunion Arena in Dallas. Civic Center Arena, Amarillo, Texas, tomorrow night starting at 8 o'clock. That's all the top stars of the NWA tomorrow night, 8 o'clock at the Civic Center Arena in Amarillo. And then tonight, 7 o'clock, Memorial Stadium, Charlotte, North Carolina. That's tonight, 7 o'clock in Charlotte at the stadium. The NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling.
They say the horsemen rule the wrestling world. The World Tag Team Champions, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard. Will they last through the Great American Bash?
Well, it's obviously, David, through the Great American Bash, we're going to run the entire spectrum. Because on July 10th in Baltimore, they will defend the World Tag Team titles. But from that point on, the horsemen are defending their pride and their dignity. And I don't care if it is a war game where you have two cages completely surrounding two rings with a cage across the top, nobody in, nobody out. It's a battle of survival of the fittest is what that's all about. And if there are other cage matches or any other type of exotic matches the promoters want to come up with during the Great American Bash, be assured of one thing, the horsemen will be ready and will reign supreme.
Arn Anderson.
David Crockett, when you go into the Great American Bash and every night you wrestle the likes of Rhodes, Sting, Luger, the Road Warriors, Dr. Death, whoever it may be, and you come out of it with your hide, it's a major accomplishment. But to go into Baltimore, Maryland, and a tag match for the world tag titles against Nikita Koloff and Sting, you got to look at all the options. You got to look at all the things that go into this match. Sting is a star that rose from nowhere. He came from something that I don't know, JJ can't describe. Tully, Rick, we've all discussed it. He's just one of those phenomenons that comes on once in a great while. Nikita Koloff, you look at the background. Nikita Koloff has been a killer from day one. They have formed a fine team and they've set their sights on these and these alone, which adds credibility and luster to the tag belts. When you're a world tag team champions, it means you're the finest at what you do in this sport. And Baltimore is a showcase for the horsemen to always shine. Now, Sting, you've talked to your friends, you've analyzed our technique, you've analyzed what we do, but they always want to be a little light. They always want to be easy on themselves, and they say, Tully's not big enough, Arn's not big enough, they're not smooth enough, they're not flashy enough, there's a chink in the armor, all you got to do is find it. Well, David Crockett, if you check the history books over the last 2 years, you'll find we didn't have to be flashy. What we had to be was champions. And that's what we did, was rise every night to what it took to be champions. Exactly what we'll do July the 10th in Baltimore. And it's been your pleasure as usual.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in Baltimore, they're going to meet Sting and Nikita Koloff. Let's go to the ring and watch Sting in action. People talking about you, you've really arrived, and to hear the horseman out here talk about Sting, there's no doubt he's arrived.
I want to tell you something else. He has a very tremendous respect for horsemen, because after the hours and hours that he has indeed looked at the videotape of the matches involving the horsemen, he has come to the realization, and many of us have, that they are the finest tag team in all of wrestling. And what a phenomenal effort it will take from this man and Nikita Koloff. But they have got the tools, Tony. Physically, they can get the job done. But it all remains to be seen what is exactly going to happen on Sunday, July the 10th, with the World Tag Team Championship on the line. The big matches are when the horsemen are at their very, very best.
And the big match is upon us. And now Sting flying through the air right onto Gary Phelps, mashing him in that neutral corner. And that is always a prelude to that Scorpion Deathlock. No one has gotten out of. No one ever has. And of course, the scene could be in Baltimore with that on one of the four horses.
A little fan there with a Great American Bash t-shirt on. The Great American Bash, great family sports entertainment for the whole family, young and old alike. And this maneuver is certainly unique. Sting wanted to say hello, Tony, to all the fans that he will see tonight in Charlotte. And I know he's looking forward to be back in Texas this Sunday in Amarillo and this Monday in Dallas. With maneuvers like this, the Stinger has captivated crowds all over the country. And in just a few moments,
He'll be standing by with David Crockett at ringside with a very special interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, they say he came out of nowhere, but he's going somewhere, all the way to the top.
Sometimes I wonder where I came from myself. I'm going to make this short, and I'm going to make it ever so sweet, because I'm like the majority of the people, sick and tired, David, of Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, week after week, with those belts around their waist, diamonds this, limousines that, just like the nature boy with his big beak nose. First of all, you guys ain't cool enough, because you don't have a hair. You don't have a haircut. Matter of fact, I said it first, right the first time, you don't have hair on your head, either one of you. Nikita's got the right haircut. I got the right haircut. July 10th in Baltimore. Woo! Yeah! Be ready, because you're going to lose those belts. I'm sick and tired of hearing you guys shoot off your mouth later.
The Great American Bash. Watch it. And the Great American Bash all over the country. We're into the bash season and fans, record-setting crowds all across the country. We talked about Charlotte tonight, Amarillo tomorrow night, and Dallas, of course, on the 4th of July. Hello to all the fans. Miami in Tampa, Florida, at Tampa Stadium coming up on Wednesday. The state capital, North Carolina, the Dorton Arena in Raleigh. Pittsburgh in the Civic Arena. And then 1 week from tonight, a big event in Chicago, the UIC Pavilion. But that's not all. The fans, the atmosphere, the excitement, the matches, and the athletes.
And, of course, Tony, there's so many great matches. All roads leading, of course, to the big one in Baltimore on Sunday, July the 10th. And many of the fans, perhaps a little bit confused as to exactly how they can see the event in Baltimore. If you don't have a ticket and plan on being there live, then you can see it in the comfort of your own home through the courtesy of pay-per-view television. It will not be shown here on TBS or your local television station. It will not be shown here on TBS or your local station, but your local cable company can give you that information. But the intensity, the record-setting crowds all over the country have seen it. The Great American Bash, I have never seen anything like it. It was, without a doubt, the hottest sports entertainment ticket in town. We hope that you get yours early.
Okay, fans, we're ready for more action right now. Let's go to the ring. Now Perez, Gary Hart against George South. You know, we touched on the athletes as part of the Great American Bash. Certainly the Latin heartthrob, as that sign would indicate, is one of the top athletes, but still one of the top athletes who has a man that he has to think about all the time, and that is a man called the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff.
Well, Al Perez and Nikita Koloff are very, very evenly paired individuals. Both men in excellent condition. They can go the distance if necessary. They both have a high degree of intensity. But Al Perez has got some tremendous amateur background. He's a Tampa, Florida native. He'll be in Tampa this Wednesday night at Tampa Stadium, Tony. Basically a homecoming for Al Perez of sorts. As George South went for the dropkick, but Perez very quick. Nobody home on that one. But when you talk about Al Perez, you've got to address the situation with the brutality of the Russian chain match. That is Nikita Koloff specialty. He learned it from his uncle Ivan Koloff. He has mastered it. And this man, Gary Hart, must contend with that Russian chain. And it's going to be really something to get Al Perez ready for the match of his lifetime against Nikita Koloff.
The match of his lifetime. Right, and just in the same breath, when you talk about a scaffold match or a war games, the match beyond, you know you're going to go into a Russian chain match, and Perez must realize this. He puts on the spinning toehold and come out with a little bit less of yourself.
Well, that's exactly right. And I want to tell you something. When you talk about leaving it all on the line, there's the bell. We're going to be hearing from Lex Luger and Dusty Rhodes, who will indeed leave it all out there when it's all said and done in their quest to gain the championships that many people think they rightfully deserve. And Al Perez, let's take another look here, Tony. This is a great move.
All right, here it is, the spinning toehold from Al Perez. Confrontation. Yes, it is with Nikita Koloff. Right now, the Latin heartthrob is with David Crockett, he and Gary Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen, Al Perez, Gary Hart, the Great American Bash, taking America by storm. It's in Amarillo, Texas, Houston, and it is in Dallas.
Dallas, Texas, July the 4th.
if you want to see the greatest wrestling extravaganza that has ever happened to the Metroplex, and I'm talking about the whole entire Metroplex, I'm talking as far as San Angelo, Texas, Abilene, Waco, Waxahachie. If you want to see the greatest wrestling extravaganza in air-conditioned comfort, there's only one place on July the 4th, and that is in the air-conditioned 19,000-seat Reunion Arena, and the place is going to be jumping. It may be 115 outside, but when you walk into that beautiful Reunion, the home of the Mavericks, the home of Al Perez and Gary Hart, it's going to be hot outside, but inside it's going to be so cool for everybody in that building except you, Nikita. We're going to make it so hot on you that you will run from the ring in shame. You're coming to Al Perez's area in Dallas, Texas, Reunion Arena. We're going to finish you off, Russian. You ain't walking out of this one. You're going to be carried out, because when it comes to Texas-style wrestling, other than Dusty Rhodes, the other one that does it best is none other than Al Perez.
All right, July 10th, the Baltimore, the Tower of Doom. Al Perez is one of the participants in that event.
This is an event that Kevin Sullivan has put together. It is the most diabolical, it is the most vicious and crucial match that Al Perez has ever been in, and we're going to get the job done.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, more action to come right after these messages. Jimmy Garvin and the very lovely Precious come to the ring against Agent Steel. It appears that she is very attentive, very happy to be with him. It appears.
Well, right now, who knows how she's going to be, and I don't want to cast any stones because I certainly don't hold any animosity toward a beautiful creature like that. But she certainly is acting a little schizophrenic, if I might use that term. Agent Steel sent to the corner by gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And I tell you something, I've got one of the most uneasy feelings of going into any match that I have ever had with this Tower of Doom situation on Sunday, July the 10th in Baltimore. You've just got to think, well, when 10 men get inside a three-story cage with trap doors, ladders leading up to the very top cage to get in it, and with her holding the key at the bottom, there's so many things that can happen, and so many bad things, Tony, I guess that's what I'm trying to say, that can happen in that environment.
The bad things we can only assume because we've never seen it before. It has never been done. It certainly isn't much of anything else. We take a look at the Brain Buster. Intriguing. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, Precious, walking up to the ring, and Jim Ross said that she would be here with us. She is here with us today. Let's take a look once again at the Brain Buster Suplex.
You know, Tony, I didn't get to find out exactly what the deal was with her and Kevin Sullivan, but I'm going to say this. Something's going on, no doubt about it. And something's going on right here. There is the Brain Buster by gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And David's got Precious here. Let's go to David Crockett very quickly.
All right,
David,
go ahead. Precious,
David.
You look fantastic.
Oh, really.
You a little nervous?
No,
you know what this is?
Kevin, I don't know what it is. I think I know what it is, and I think I want it.
You want this?
Kevin, why are you doing this?
Why am I doing it to you? Because you humiliated me on TV and said I was a liar. I still believe what's in this. You know, I still believe everything that's here.
Kevin, why don't you just give it to me right now?
I ain't giving this. Oh, yeah, just hand it over to you.
Settle this right now, Kevin.
We can settle it?
Yes, Kevin. Uh-huh.
We can settle it? Yeah? What will you do for this? You know what I want.
Kevin, What do I have to do for it, Kevin? What do I have to do for it, Kevin?
What do you have to do for it? What do you have to do for it, Patty?
Kevin.
What do you have to do for it? I'll tell you what you have to do. Come here. You want it? You want it? In Baltimore, you'll get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back.
Main event, the biggest, the best, the hardest hitting, and the most spectacular arena bouts in America can be seen on Superstation TBS. It's all action, and it's all right here. The NWA Main Event, 5:35 Eastern on Superstation TBS Sunday.
Every time I see Kevin Sullivan, I think that the people of the Metal Ward over at Grady are looking intently at what's going on. Because Kevin Sullivan, not only is he maniacal, but he's very confident about what he's doing, and that is scary.
I wonder if that straitjacket Jim Cornette's going to be in on July the 10th is one size fits all, because Kevin Sullivan needs some use out of it after July the 10th. If things don't go the way that he wants in the Tower of Doom, he needs to be committed anyway. There you see him.
Fans, this is a match for the NWA World Television title. Rotunda, the champion, one fall, 10-minute time limit. It's a man, young man named Tony Super, who certainly has all the ability in the world, but not the experience of a Mike Rotunda, nor does he have the people around the side of the ring with him as Rotunda does.
You know, Tony, we're going to be, as you mentioned, in Amarillo tomorrow night. The fans that cannot be in Amarillo can join us on the 900 number, our 900 number broadcast. And look at this, double-teaming Tony Super here in the studio while Rotunda's got Teddy Long detained on the other side of the ring. They are tying up Super with that kind of a jump rope. Looks more like an outdoor extension cord. And he gets slapped right in the chest. And now right to the head, Steiner. You know, we have said it so many times. He has as much purpose out here as you and I would have in the corner for Tony Super.
You're right.
No purpose at all.
Absolutely none.
Except to cause trouble. Well, you know, he's a little deranged, too. He's probably walks in the same steps as his mentor, the Games Master, closer than anybody in the varsity club. As Super, the big man, 300 pounds, back in Rotunda, back into the corner. I want to tell you something. The Metroplex in Dallas, Texas is red hot and ready for the NWA's only scheduled appearance in the Metroplex this summer, and that's this Monday night, the 4th of July. You know, the Reunion Arena has great air conditioning. I heard Gary Hart talking about that.
Okay. Glad to know that. Is Rotunda, it's right across the throat now. Super, want to let you know that Rotunda very confident, and of course we consider him, we have to, one of the top world television champions of all time. He's held it since January and on a regular basis has been defending the title successfully. But this summer, the challenge is there from not only Sting, a man we've seen before, but Dr. Death, Steve Williams, certainly big threats to that world television title.
Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and Mike Rotunda have really sparked a rivalry between each other. I think it runs past a little bit of collegiate pride there. Both men, former two-sport starters in college. Of course, Rotunda at Syracuse and Dr. Death at Oklahoma. And there's a great rivalry between these two men that has developed in recent weeks. And we have seen a tremendous battle between these two men. Rick Steiner there covers the screen pretty much with that wide back of his.
Sullivan, his mind is elsewhere. Look at him. Looking at that letter or envelope, whatever it is, and a very confident look on his face. There's your double arm over the top suplex and your winner, and as expected, still the world television champion, Mike Rotunda.
You know, not to digress from this outstanding television champion, because he's as good an NWA TV champion as ever has been. But when Precious gets around that crazy man right there with that robe on, she changes. There is something in the past. I wish we knew what it was, but there's something there between Kevin Sullivan and Precious.
Still more to come. We'll be talking to the Total Package, Lex Luger, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and more.
Don't you go away.
Here from Baltimore, Lex Luger will go after the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. Then the living legend, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
will challenge Barry Windham for the U.S. title. Dusty.
Well, David, I think that Barry Windham just come out here just a little bit too passive, if you will. J.J. Dillon talking about game plans, talking about Baltimore, talking about the Great American Bash. I'm tired of talking about it. I'm tired of living with the fact that Barry Windham has something that belongs to me. Dusty Rhodes, the American dream, the United States heavyweight title belongs to me. And everybody from Atlanta to Podunk, Union, Illinois, know that when you take something from Dusty Rhodes, the American dream, you got to pay the price. You got to pay the price. And the price is the price for freedom. And now, then, the bottom line with the Nature Boy. Be coming out here with no towel, just a little bit jewelry. Are you just a little bit on the edge, Nature Boy? Are you a little bit edgy? Because I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to tell the wrestling fans, that Lex Luger, my friend, Lex Luger is the next World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion.
Lex?
You know, David, first off, I'd like to say that James Day for Barry Windham, you better have one hell of a game plan this time around, because, brother, the American Dream will be the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion very soon. You know, to travel with the Great American Bashes, it is just 1 week away. What I'm talking about is 8 days, Nature Boy, and I am possessed. I am obsessed with the idea of wrestling you in Baltimore. Because you see, Nature Boy, for all these years you've been a champ, you've won it. You've won so many matches, and when you've lost it, you've regained it. But you know why you've avoided me so long? It's for the same reason I see those bags on your eyes right now. I hear that angst in your voice, because you know I'm different. Because you see, you said, I specialize, oh baby, in big men. Well, get a full shot. This is one big man you haven't specialized in yet, and you never will. You know it, and I know it. But you see, that's your boy. There's payback to be made in Baltimore for Miami and everything else, and the long wait you've made me have. I've got an hour to do with you whatever I want to do. And the bottom line is this, as great a champion as you've been, all the guys you've wrestled, all the times you've lost, you see that your boy, you know, and I know, that when, not if, when I win that title, there will be no sixth time, Nature Boy, because then you gotta beat the total package. When the champion has the advantage, you gotta put my shoulders down. And I'm telling you right now, it won't happen. So, Nature Boy, you're on the edge of the cliff in Baltimore. You're hanging on. And I'm going to be one standing there to step on your fingers and send you down that cliff.
July 10th in Baltimore. That's where the action's going to be. In the ring now, the Fantastic. There you see Tommy Rogers carrying around that straitjacket as Bobby Fulton leaps over the top rope. Into the ring is going to be Mike Jackson and Curtis Thompson challenging the reigning United States Tag Team Champions. And they certainly, as well as Dusty Rhodes and Lex Luger, Sting and Nikita Koloff, these two young men have a major challenge ahead of them in Baltimore. When Jim Cornette, if it comes out the way I know the majority of the fans would like to see it with the Fantastic victorious, then Jim Cornette's going to be lowered down from about 50 feet above the ring, all comfy in that straight jacket, and then they're going to lash him with a leather strap.
It was in Chattanooga, Tennessee, also, where they won those U.S. Tag Team belts, and they'll be going back to Chattanooga the 14th of this month against the Midnight Express, and it's going to be one of those matches that's way up in the air.
You bet. 20 feet above the ring. A great arm drag takedown, and a nice reversal by Mike Jackson, but very quickly, Bobby Fulton is out.
And Jackson going for the pinning predicament. Mike Jackson, of course, a veteran. Sitting here many times on TBS. Mike's a great competitor, but he's in there with one of the finest, the smoothest tag teams in wrestling. That's the Fantastics. And speaking of great tag teams, oh, what a drop kick by Tommy Rogers. Rogers is a, what a drop kick he's got. The Rock and Roll Express with us also, Tony, here today. Nice drop toehold by Tommy Rogers. Wrist lock on powerful Curtis Thompson. Jim Cornette's going to be out here. He's got some comments to make, I'm sure, that will be priceless regarding his situation in Baltimore. Powerful clothesline by Curtis Thompson. Still to come, Ivan Koloff and the giant Russian assassin. We're going to hear from the Road Warriors. We're going to see Dr. Death Steve Williams in action. We're going to see the Sheep Herders in action and much more. All yet to come here on the Superstation.
One of the true great athletes in our sport right there, Tommy Rogers, who came right off of the top. He is full of quickness, of power, and they make such a great tag team. Fans love him so much that it's easy to see why Cornette hates him, because they represent everything he dislikes.
Powerful Curtis Thompson kicks out at a two count here. Well, I'll tell you something. This is a great team. And they have certainly been a thorn in the side of the Midnight Express. They have proven that they can beat the Midnight Express, which very few teams have ever done. And if they can do it in Baltimore, then Jim Cornette will be lashed. And I mean, you've got to think of that. When they lower him down from high up in the Baltimore arena and they get the opportunity to hang him over those ropes and really lash him, they're going to take their time and savor every single lash on Master James E. Cornette.
Thompson now trying to make the tag. It does so to Mike Jackson. Jackson, quick himself, but nothing to compare with these two men as Tommy Rogers gets in the high backdrop and goes right at him. The Fantastics. Certainly, with Cornette high above the ring in his straitjacket, one would think that Cornette would be neutralized. But it is almost on the same line of with the Horsemen. And that is, when you think you got him at your mercy, that's when something goes awry. There's your high vertical suplex. And now, here's the tag again. On par with what the Midnight Express do, here's your rocket launcher down on top of Curtis Thompson.
And if they can execute that maneuver with that effectiveness on Sunday, July the 10th in Baltimore in the arena, then Jim Cornette will be lowered from high above the ring. He'll be wearing that straitjacket from the time the match starts, and then he will be lashed and given the whipping that his mama never gave him. A trip to the woodshed may be in line for Jim Cornette.
Okay, now let's go to David Crockett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, July 10th in Baltimore, this man will be in a straitjacket.
Let me tell you something right now. The Great American Bash is catching fire like wildfire all over the country. It's burning from one end to the other. And July the 10th, Baltimore, Maryland, is getting closer and closer and closer. The Fantastics are going to put the U.S. Tag Team title on the line against the Midnight Express. The loser gets 10 lashes. The winner gets the belt. But what's more, in an outright blatant attempt to humiliate me, to make me look like an idiot, they're going to stick me in a straitjacket and hang me 50 feet in the air over that ring. Now, I realize, David, that you and Larry and Curly over there would love to see me in a straitjacket. And I realize the Fantastics and the NWA would love to see me in a straitjacket. But the American people are behind me, brother, just like they always are, and behind the Midnight Express, one of the most prestigious publications in America today, Pulitzer Prize winners in journalism, the Weekly World News, the first ones to break headlines like Adam and Eve found in Asia, World War II bomber plane found on the moon, injured UFO crew in Soviet hospital, and of course, Elvis is alive. He was seen at a Burger King in Kalamazoo, Michigan. These guys are on top of things, and right here in the latest issue, right here on the editorial page next to the science column where it says that an expert says dinosaurs honk like Buicks, it says that in a survey taken of the population of Butte, Montana, 95% of the people did not want to see Jim Cornette get put in a straitjacket. 2% did, and 3% were unavailable for comment. And brother, there you have it. But I don't care who's behind me, the American public, or anybody else, as long as the Midnight Express is. And I'll tell you this, Fantastic. After you have finished on July the 10th, humiliating me by putting me in a straitjacket after you have finished on July the 10th, embarrassing me by putting me in that cage, and after you finished on July the 10th, petrifying me and scaring me to death by hanging me up in the air 50 feet over the ring. Well, then there's an old saying that goes like this, brother. He who laughs last, laughs best. And believe you me, when I'm hung up there after I've been petrified and humiliated and embarrassed, when I see the Midnight Express take those U.S. Tag Team title belts from you, when I see you get whipped like the dogs that you are, when I see that I'm hanging up there and I'm not there to be able to pull the Midnight Express off of you, brother, then fantastic. I'm going to be laughing. I'm going to be laughing, and so is everybody else, because we're going to embarrass you and humiliate you. But for me to be put in a straitjacket and not be able to guide my great champions on a victory is ridiculous, David Crockett. Do you realize they never even tied my hands up when I was little, and I used to be hyperactive when I was a child, but I got all that taken care of with medication. But I'll tell you this, man, we're going to get you one way or the other. I just hope I don't get hurt, Bobby. You know how long it'll be all the way up.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, July 10th in Baltimore, he's going to be in a straitjacket. Let's go to the ring, the Rock and Roll Express.
The Rock and Roll Express are back right here on the Superstation against Bob Riddle and Joe Cruz. You know, if we can quickly touch on something that Jim Cornette said about Butte, Montana.
Yes.
I know a lot of great people in Butte, Montana. And I certainly hope in the near future they get a television set so they can really see what Jim Cornette is like.
And you think he wants us to believe that he bought all those tabloids. He found them in the bus station where he hangs around quite often. They were free because he's not going to spend that much money on anything. Now, the Rock and Roll Express are here, and they're here for a reason. They want to set the record, unprecedented, five times as tag team champions of the world. I'll tell you something. They've won it four times. I'm not going to bet against them from regaining those titles. The Rock and Roll Express, with all the ability in the world, we know that, all the fan support, and of course, to NWA as they give a high double backdrop to Bob Riddle to come into the NWA and say we are going to be champions for the fifth time means you got to do it by going right through the Four Horsemen. And very frankly, as you said earlier, Jim Ross, and correctly so, the greatest tag team of the world right now. Well, Robert Gibson and Ricky Morton have been partners in and out of the ring for a long, long time, and they have no wasted motion. They know exactly what they're here for. They know exactly what they're going to do. They always come to the ring with a great game plan, and they can adapt to any style, no doubt about that. They can adapt to any style, and our international flavor in tag team wrestling will continue in the hour with the Russian duo of Ivan Koloff and the Russian Assassin. The New Zealand Sheepherders will be here wrestling, and they have got a real vendetta against Ricky and Robert as well.
That's true, and you know, when you talk about being world tag team champions, it doesn't mean you're just going to go and wrestle Arn and Tully exclusively. Back in the NWA, there's a lot of competition. There's a lot of people out there that would like to not only set up roadblocks to prevent, but would also like to hurt this team, and those two men are Butch Miller and Luke Williams, the New Zealand Sheepherder.
Joe Cruz in there, right hand buried by Ricky Morton. Morton and Gibson controlling the action here. We're also going to hear from the Legion of Doom, the awesome Road Warriors, here in the balance of our program as well. Double team. Team moves one after the other. They can really put it in succession. Bob Riddle came in, and he just went out as quickly as he got here.
That's a new move going right to the hole. Both men into the corner, and now set up. Down goes Joe Cruz from the patented double dropkick from Ricky and Robert. They are back. They are looking as good as ever, and they are certainly worthy of a world tag team title shot against, of course, Tully and Arn. But first things first, and that, of course, is the Great American Bash. And the battle's at hand right now as Joe Cruz goes down. We'll be back, and David will talk to the Rock and Roll in just a short second.
Well, Express, a very big part of the Great American Bash.
You know, Dave, you know, we know strangers nobody around the world. I do a double jockey goes to show you. We can beat anybody. Let me tell you something, guys. The Great American Bash coming around, we want the NWA World Tag Team title for the fifth time.
All right, yeah, you talk about...
That's right, David.
But Bash is not the only reason the Rock and Roll Express are back here, baby. We're back here for a lot of different reasons. You see, we've been around the country. That's right, we've been around the country, but we've been kicking tail just to stay in shape, baby, to show you what it's all about. Because we know that we are back in the National Wrestling Alliance, the toughest wrestling of all time, bar none, baby, bar none. But like we said, we're here for a reason. 5-time NWA World Tag Team Champions. And that's a promise to all these young men that stand behind us, baby, that we are here. That's right, baby. Rock and roll is back, and rock and roll is here to stay. Yeah!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Great American Bash, it's coming your way, so watch it.
Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross, Tony Schiavone, and David Crockett back with you here on the Superstation as we take a look at Paul Jones' Russian duo. Of course, the veteran, the Russian Bear Ivan Koloff, and the giant Russian 6'8", 350 pounds, the Russian Assassin. And Mr. Jones is joining us here at ringside. And I want to tell you something. This man is big. He's impressive. And he's, as we look at him, bigger than either one of the Road Warriors. Now, whether he's going to be man enough to handle him, that still remains to be seen.
Well, you know, Jim Ross, I'm glad you made the statement about the man's size bigger than the Road Warriors, because if I would have said it, the people wouldn't believe it. Well, let me tell you something right now. You know, before I put my men in the bashes and these scaffold matches, I sit down and I ask myself, who are these bashes for? For the winner, or is it for the loser? But no, it's for the fan. It's for the wrestling fan that wants revenge, what they call revenge. But brother, let me tell you something right now. My men are ready for these bashes. Look at this fan right here. Look at the power. Now, you cannot deny that.
Well, I certainly can't. At 6 feet 8, 350 pounds, he's the largest Russian athlete ever to compete in American rings here. But you go all over the world, and you go to a country like Japan. I don't know if the people in Russia would agree, but a great country like Japan, they say, what about who's the toughest tag team in wrestling? They're going to tell you the Road Warriors, Paul.
Well, it's because the fans say they are. Whatever the fan says, everybody seems to believe. And whatever you commentators stand up here and tell the fans, they think it's gospel. When I get up here and I tell somebody, I've got to go out in the ring and prove it. And that's exactly what we're going to do in the bashes.
This man is really awesome. And I want to tell you something. Ivan Koloff, I know, has given this man a gut check. He can trust this man. He knows he's going to be there when the going gets tough. And it's going to get real tough, Paul, 20 feet above the ring.
That's right, Jim. I feel so secure when I have a solid team here, a thoroughbred team, two Russians. And look at this here. There's no way a man can escape.
That is one of the most deadly maneuvers, the Russian guillotine. This man is so big and so strong. The pending confrontation with the Road Warriors is going to be awesome. But we're going to hear from the Road Warriors this program as well, Mr. Jones. All right, Tony. One more look at this maneuver.
The Russian guillotine. It is awesome. It certainly could put somebody out of the sport. And that's what, as this is going on, that's what they're trying to do at the base of the ring right now. Your winners, Paul Jones's Ivan Koloff and the Russian Assassin.
Paul Jones says his Russian Assassin is bigger than the Road Warriors.
You know something, David Crockett? He may be bigger. He's 6'8", 350. That's okay. We've faced big men in the past. But you know, he's got to have it. He's got to have the hatred right here. We even hate a lot of Americans. And we especially do not like you, Ivan Koloff, or that stinking Russian Assassin. You're going to find out what kind of hatred we've got built up in us. When we get you on the Skywalkers. You know, David, the Great American Bash, we got Tower of Doom coming up, Baltimore, Maryland. A lot of people are going to feel a lot of pain from the Warriors. You know, Hawk and I, we were kind of chuckling back there. We listened to the Four Horsemen interview. We listened to Paul Jones out here. You know, it's kind of funny. We liked it. They show a lot of spunk. We're going to feel good kicking your teeth down your throat, right, Hawk?
You know something?
when me and Animal were in St. Child's Reformatory beating up all those other kids. We were young men, see? We were never kids. They said, boys, it's got to stop. You should get in the ring and do it as professionals if you like it that much. Well, isn't it a fact that that's what we're doing now? And isn't it also a fact that we're the very best tag team in professional wrestling? Yes, it is a fact. It's a fact because I said so. That's why this is the machine that drives professional wrestling. And this is the motor that tells the machine what to do. Precious Paul, number one manager of all time. Tell him, Paul.
You know, David Crockett, I listen to Kevin Sullivan, and he's a very powerful, intense, sick individual. And I see that his power comes from one thing. And Kevin Sullivan, you're always exploiting contradiction. You're a sick man. You've devised a sick match. But there's one thing that's sicker, and that's the Legion of Doom. We're the maddest of the mad, and we'll see you in Baltimore.
That's right, Baltimore, the Tower of Doom, Skywalkers, War Games, it's all part of the Great American Bash. Let's go to the ring and Dr. Death, Steve Williams.
The one and only Dr. Death, Steve Williams, against Ryan Wagner. The intensity is picking up. You know, it really doesn't take something like the Great American Bash to get the Road Warriors fired up. They're always that way.
Can you imagine Dr. Death and the Road Warriors together in the Tower of Doom in Baltimore? Ronnie Garvin and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. There's, you know, Jimmy Garvin's a finesse wrestler in the past. Now he has been pushed into a corner with Kevin Sullivan where he's fighting for his life, and he can handle himself. But Ronnie Garvin, Dr. Death, and the Road Warriors have had that tough man image, that tough guy image, and they've earned it. And some of this is say, well, they're tough. Dr. Death and the Oklahoma Stampede, boy, he didn't work by the hour, does he?
I can foresee, as he has his hand raised in victory, I can foresee that during the Tower of Doom, if the trap door doesn't open in time, for them just to rip one of the tops off of it.
Well, they're strong enough and powerful enough to do it. I'll tell you something. The Tower of Doom, what's going to happen? Dr. Death, Steve Williams and company involved in that bizarre matchup. But look at 288 pounds. He's all man. He caught Ryan Wagner, who weighs 245 or 250, right in midair. And the doctor with a patented Oklahoma Stampede and yet another victory here on the Superstation. And the doctor is standing by with David Crockett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in Baltimore on the 10th, Ric Flair wrestles Lex Luger. The World Heavyweight Championship's on the line. And then Dr. Death, Steve Williams, is in the Tower of Doom.
First of all, David, Mike Rotunda, you're out here throwing quarters around. You better be holding on to those quarters because you're going to have to call somebody. Mike Rotunda, go back to your ex-teammates. Ask Gene Mills how tough I am. Ask Bruce Braungartner, Olympic champion, how tough I am. Mike Rotunda, before the summer's over, the belt will be around my waist. Now, David, it's kickoff time. The AP and UPI poll came out, and you know who's on top of the list, don't you?
Who is?
Lex Luger, Dusty Rhodes, the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair. You've got your hands full now. Now the Tower of Doom. One thing, I'm forgetting my good friend Dusty Rhodes, Barry Windham. You are the student. You are the student. When the dream gets in the ring, brother, it's time to go back to school. The Tower of Doom, Baltimore, July 10th. I am the sheriff. I am the law. When I get in that Tower of Doom, Kevin Sullivan, my good friend, the Garvins, you'll never even come close to Precious and my very close friends, the Road Warriors. If you don't think there's some beef in that ring, you've got another thing coming. Because when we all step in there and the doors close, you boys have to look right across and look right into our eyes. Look very closely, because hell is gonna break out.
The whole world is watching in Baltimore on July 10th. More action right after this.
We are taking a look at certainly one of the most bizarre assemblages we've ever seen. Now the New Zealand War Haka. The salute, the homage to the New Zealand flag from Rip Morgan, who seems to have a couple of screws loose himself, and of course, the New Zealand Sheepherders.
Well, these men are certainly no strangers to wrestling fans anywhere, especially in the great state of Florida, as they will be in Tampa at Tampa Stadium this Wednesday night in one of the biggest wrestling cards, if not the biggest in Florida wrestling history, this Wednesday night outdoors at Tampa Stadium. Should be really something there, fans. Also, Jim, want to say hello to all of our fans in Miami at the Knight Center. Also, the Dorton Arena in Raleigh, Pittsburgh at the Civic Arena, of course. We talked in depth about the 4th of July in Dallas, Amarillo. And don't forget, if you can join us in Amarillo tomorrow night, you can always pick up a telephone and dial the wrestling hotline, listen to it, play-by-play live as it happens.
That's right. We're having a lot of fun, Tony, now doing that. We'll be in Amarillo tomorrow night. As the Sheepherders on a vendetta during the Great American Bash, whether it's the Rock and Roll Express or any other team, this is a team that you can never count out of a championship situation. They are bizarre, they are unorthodox, they're extremely hard to scout, and they are as physical as any team that you will ever see in wrestling. They've never walked away from any fight. You can look at their face and tell that. Into the corner, and now Miller goes after the man. The tag is made. Here comes Luke Williams. Double team extraordinaire right here. They are brutal. I know. Looking closely at Ricky and Robert. For Ricky and Robert to even get a chance to go after the World Tag Team Champions, they got to get through these two men. You heard Williams right there shouting rock and roll.
Well, we know that the Rock and Roll Express have made the statement that they're going to go through anybody it takes to regain the